For months, United fans have been waiting for our club to appoint the first sporting director in United's history. And during that time, we've been linked to a lot of names, like Paul Mitchell, who will be experienced and established in the role, to people like Rio Ferdinand and Darren Fletcher, and even Patrice Evra. And the variety of the name of the role, from sporting director to director of football, to technical director, to a transfer committee made up of ex-players, nobody's really known what's been going on the whole time. And now the latest report suggests that nothing is going to happen, that Ed Woodward will be maintaining power and control at United, and that the club do not expect to make an appointment of a sporting director this summer. What the hell is going on? What are United doing? I'm going to run through all of it today with you. Now, before we do begin, if you are new to United People's TV, make sure you hit the subscribe button and get involved. But let's talk about this mess that really is unfolding at United. As I said, the latest report suggests that Ed Woodward will be maintaining his position of power at United. The report suggests that Woodward will continue to dictate United's transfer policy, that United do not expect to recruit a sporting or technical director, that United have considered a sort of committee-style approach, that Mike Phelan and Solskjaer will be involved in the transfers, but that ultimately Ed Woodward's position of power with the footballing decisions at United will not change this summer. And that idea has left me absolutely fuming. Because what as fans have we been told over the last few months? We've been told that an appointment is coming shortly. We've been linked with Rio Ferdinand, Darren Fletcher. We've sat through variations of the role, sporting director, multiple technical directors. And now, at the start of June, with the summer transfer window kicking off, we're told the news that United don't expect to make an appointment. What the hell is United doing? We all knew just how important this summer was in terms of the restructuring. If we probably wanted to rebuild and reset United, that it had to come from within, that it wasn't just about signing the right players. This summer, more importantly, was about restructuring the club and getting the conditions in place for success to be built on top of it. Instead, it looks like United are just going to repeat and rinse the mistake that's dragged us towards mid-table for the last 6 years. Sack a manager, bring a new manager in, back in with lots of money in the transfer window, go down a couple of years, decide it's the manager who's the problem, sack him, bring in another manager, back that manager, rinse and repeat. It's insanity that United are doing this, but United are doing this, according to the latest reports, that we aren't going to appoint a technical or sporting, anyway, a director to take this club forward in the vision that we should be. Instead, we're doing the same old problems that have caused the situation we find ourselves in. And it's not as if the problems are hidden and behind the scenes and nobody really knows what the problems are. It's clear what the problems are. Ed Woodward, being the money man that he is in control of the footballing decisions at United. He's not qualified to do so. Therefore, everything is incorrect. Everything's in the wrong place behind the scenes. But nothing is apparently going to change. And it makes you wonder, did United ever intend to appoint a sporting director this summer? It feels now like that could have been lip service all along. That Ed Woodward and his cronies at the board level were just feeding this to the press and having minor interviews with the likes of Rio Ferdinand and Darren Fletcher and not the likes of Paul Mitchell. And that United never really intended to change the structure of the club, that Woodward never intended to relinquish power, and that United were always going to keep the same sort of structure that we've always had. That's semi what it feels like, because even if a sporting director was coming, even if tomorrow Paul Mitchell came in, was given the full job, full responsibility, it's the start of June. He wouldn't be able to impact this summer, which is the crucial summer. Solskjaer's first summer, where the big changes are going to happen in the squad. We would have needed that director to come in at the same sort of time that Solskjaer did for anything to truly change and happen this summer. So the whole thing's just been an abomination the whole way through. And I know that we dither and we dally with some signings, but this is taking the piss. For months and months and months, we've been told that United are going to appoint a director, that the structure of the club is going to change. And now at the start of June, we're told that Edward was just sitting down on his throne and maintaining power. Really? Now, some of you may think I'm overreacting when I say this, but Solskjaer will get sacked and will fail at Man United if this is the case, because the club does not have the conditions for success to happen. We needed to restructure this club behind the scenes and repair from within to create the conditions for Solskjaer to succeed at United as manager. Instead, we're going to spend big this summer. We're going to sign a few good players. But unless Solskjaer works some sort of miracle that the football changes that much, that it transcends through the veins of the club and changes the hierarchy, then nothing's going to change. Everybody wants us to replicate the recent success that Liverpool have done in terms of how they've restructured their club, because a few years ago they were a laughingstock, like United are now. But it's not just because Jurgen Klopp has come in and bought the right players. It's because behind the scenes they made the right appointments the whole way through. They allowed and created the conditions for Klopp to succeed. At United, that won't happen unless the structure changes, and the structure clearly isn't going to change until the Glazers sell. And, you know, I've said it the whole way through. I was worried that nothing was really going to change, that Edward was just going to maintain power, and that United would just plod on with the same wrong direction that's caused the chaos and mess that we're now in. And it seems that's now become the reality. Woodward is going nowhere, not from the footballing side of things. Sure, Solskjaer and Phelan might have veto over the transfer decisions, but what does that matter? Unless Edward gets his hands out of that pie, we're screwed. We truly are. And we all shook our heads with disbelief when the likes of Rio Ferdinand, Darren Fletcher were linked with technical director or sporting director roles. But give me that over Ed Woodward and the empire that he's in control of, just sitting there like an African dictator with the military in their pocket. Just, you can't get rid of them. You can't get rid of them. Until the Glazers want to sell United, it doesn't feel like we'll ever truly get rid of this structure, the problems that exist at United. And that's scary, because if I'm the Glazers, why am I going to sell United? It's making me money hand over fist. Dividends coming left, right and centre every single year. The Glazers don't need or want to sell. And clearly the on-the-pitch performances haven't affected the revenues too much, because we're going up and up and up in terms of the share value. But as a fan, it's horrific to watch. And just the news that Woodward will be maintaining control and power means this summer's a failure for me. It doesn't matter what happens. If we sign Wan-Bissaka, we sign Koulibaly, we sign Neves, even Sancho comes. It doesn't matter, because I know that a year, 18 months down the line, the same problems are going to resurface. The same issues are going to happen with the manager and the club and everything to do with it. Short-term transfers, a good summer, won't hide the fact that the long-term problems exist at this club, and you can't build long-term success until the problems are sorted at the root. And the root is the Glazers, and we all know that's never really going to change. And it doesn't seem like Ed Woodward's going to change either. And that's fucking scary. The reality here might well be that United never really truly intended to appoint a sporting director. Not in the full sense. It always felt like it might have been a power struggle between Ed Woodward and any candidate that came in. It doesn't take that long. Sure, it'll take time and you want to make the right decision, but it doesn't take months and months and months and months and months to appoint a sporting director if the conditions of the club and the job spec are correct. But if I was Paul Mitchell, look, I'd say, why would I go near there when I could be the head of Red Bull operations globally and be actually in control, rather than having Ed Woodward looming over my shoulder like a devil? And that's what Ed Woodward is. And nothing seems to be changing. So it seems like Woodward will be maintaining his seat on the Iron Throne, and that nothing and no rebellion, no resistance is going to change that. Not while the Glazers are still in charge and own United. Now, what do you make of all this mess? Am I overreacting? Do you think Solskjaer can succeed at this club? But don't worry, Sam, get the right players in, it will change the mentality, it will change the vision of the club on the pitch, and that will transcend through the whole club. I don't think it will. I think in a year, 18 months' time, we're going to have the same damn conversations we've been having for the last 6 years, and I'm bored of them. And I thought this summer was the chance to truly change the club. But the powers that be, it sounds like they don't want to let go of that power. Might not be a surprise, but it's not what I wanted to hear. And I want to hear from you. Let me know what you think about all this in the comments below, as always. If you're new to United People's TV and you're still here, make sure you subscribe. Till next time, though, take it easy.